I love these broken visibility mechanics. Watch this. I can see all the way over there. I can see the zoning tank right there. Go to first person. Yeah, I can actually see that one, but there was another one behind him that I was able to see in third person, but not see in first person. Or gunner sight mode. Target damaged, of course. It's an S2. One way of thinking that the fucking 12.8 centimeter gun can penetrate an S2. Tracked him that time, wow. I actually did something to him. Quite surprised. Got that guy then. That was a weird penetration. Damaged. Magical AS2s. It's so magic. Oh, I love rushing bias in this game. Honest. Of course, he was killed literally a millisecond before I fired that shot. Wow. Finally. That was the same tank that I shot three times before. Left. T-44. Shit, I'm dead. Maybe. Maybe not. But my dude, the stub bomb's coming in. So maybe. Since, yep. Oh, there we go. No ammo, that's the problem. I need to get in a cap now. And more bombs. Let's pretend I'm dead. Oh, that kind of worked. Motherfucker. Oh, that's real. I fought rainbows and ride unicorns. What? Norwegian sense of humor. Six. Okay, let's get a couple more rounds and then we'll push. I do get bumped, just not killed for it. I've had plenty of times when I've been bumped before, dude. One of the reasons why I don't tend to get bombed is I don't tend to stay in the same spot. That's quite a big secret for it. Because by staying static, you're making yourself an easy target for bombers. Or, you know, aircraft with bombs. I wouldn't say this is a perfect example of that. I mean, like, when that year two was bombing me earlier on, when I was on that ridge just there, I was on the reverse slope, so he couldn't effectively get shots on me. And, or bombs on me. Any bombs that were landed on that, on the eastern side of the hill, just wouldn't affect me at all. Because of the actual, you know, layout of the ground. It meant that you couldn't get a clear shot. Didn't survive that one. Looks like I'm gonna have to bring a plane and clear out the skies. Oh, I've got a good plane for that. This one. There were four left, and I know they've got two planes up. I think they've actually got three. Which means they've got one on the ground, maybe? P-51D just crashed on their team, so that could be one of those. Let's get rid of the bomb. Don't think I'll be needing that one. Yeah, 9P just crashed on their team. And the TBF is fucked. So let's get the Wiven. Well, maybe not. Where's the Wiven? Has the Wiven crashed and died as well? Shit, I'm just dropped that bomb as well. I'm assuming that they're gonna have stuff on the ground. Can't see the Wiven anyway. Yep, there we go. Great, just there. That was a nice two. And they're going to the tank. Looking the rice too. Could be mistaken, that might be a Pershing. No, I don't have the Wiven. I'm not intending to get it until it's on sale. He's dead. And And they've got another tank in. Oh, this one's AA. That's ZSU, I think. Oh, that one M19. That'll do. That'll do nicely. And I've got another IS-2 in. But we wouldn't. I think went some way to get in the filters and not, at least. I suppose that's not bad. What happened to the, you know, bonus for using the vehicle previous to the one that you're actually researching? Because that's not that much of a bonus, if I'm honest. When I was flying out the LA-9, I was getting a footload more than that. Yes. That's the problem, because I'm trying to compare aircraft RP to ground forces RP.